Have you ever received a recommendation that was so normal and unadventurous that it just leaves you offended? I once helped my best friend with helping a member of their family moving. Afterwards, I turned to my friend of then 23 years and said something along the lines of, "By golly, good sir, I am famished. Where could a quaint fellow such as myself find a remedy for this hunger?" Knowing me, he could have appreciated the level of which I like to explore new restaurants and try new foods. Having known each other our entire lives, he would have had that knowledge. He would know that I had spent 10,000 hours in culinary arts and would have a modest appreciation for cuisine. He would know that someone like me isn't looking for an Applebee's or a Chili's. I'm looking for a good food recommendation. So naturally, he suggested Arby's. If you were to take a poll of video gamers on their video gaming recommendations for real and authentic gamers over the past year, I think you wouldn't be bemused to find the results rather self-evident. Baldur's Gate 3, Spider-Man 2, Lethal Company, Helldivers 2, maybe a Ready or Not or an underground gem such as Minecraft. Great games, sure, but I smell you. I see you with my nose. You want that good. You want that recommendation that you haven't heard 100 times. Let me lead you to your table. I have prepared for you 4 courses ripe to freak your gamer senses. Welcome to episode 2 of Media Mashup. My name is RKH, and I will be your sommelier. Each game recommendation will come with an album recommendation to suit the mood. My qualifications for this job are as listed as such. First up, we have Haven. Tonight, we'll be preparing Haven with You by Rosie Lowe. Haven was developed and produced by Gamer Bakers. I think it's Game Bakers, I don't know what the fuck. Haven is an action-adventure RPG with romance visual novel elements. This game is perfect for anyone who is interested in third-wheeling. There is a healthy amount of game where you play as you or Kay, the main characters, but what sticks with me is the part of the game played within the Hive, their ship. While in the Hive, you don't play as you or Kay, but instead operate a free-roaming first-person perspective. You can disengage this modus operandi by interacting with objects or with the characters. This will launch a scene or dialogue depending on the moods of you or Kay. The voice dialogue is fine, I would rank it higher, but they left in some questionable moments of narration that detracted from my overall experience. Haven has a combat system that reminds me of Rock, Paper, Scissors, but is probably supposed to remind me of another game's combat system. Unfortunately, I'm not that much of a weeb, so the reference was lost on me. Your main goal is to blow up and act like you don't know nobody, but then after that, your secondary goal is to locate pieces of your ship that were blown off by a seismic event. You and Kay, being on the lam, are desperate to repair their ship in the event that they must once again flee. I did not finish Haven, so my experience with the game will be limited to the first 3 hours of play. I don't believe that this will provide a fair judgment of the whole game, and if the game looks like it'd be interesting to you, by all means check it out.
Good one.
Is very subjective, you.
In any case, these boots are working. We should try them with that thread we weren't able to use last time.
Do you remember where it was?
The mapping module certainly does.
Following your hors d'oeuvres, I present you with the appetizer for tonight. Disc room and its accompaniment, Uvoid synthesizer by Machine Girl. Now this is a game for me. Disc Room is an action, puzzle, dungeon crawler, bullet hell, disc hell? This game is frustratingly hard, but it also incentivizes dying. I loved playing Disc Room. While in between calls at work, I would just play it for a few minutes, and it added to the overall tenseness of the game, knowing that any second I could get a call and then have to take my attention away from the game for several minutes at a time. Fuck it, start all over. Disc Room was developed by Terry, Dose One, Kitty, and JW, and published by Devolver Digital. Devolver has become my favorite publisher over the past 2 years. I love them and their silly little videos. Shout out to the devs too. I bought almost all of your stuff available on Steam. I'm really looking forward to playing Minute and High Hell. If you watched my previous video on ATS, you may have caught the Sludge Life 2 gameplay in the intermission. Sludge Life 2 was my first experience with the developer Terry Veltman. Shout out to Terry, Kitty, and JW, and especially shout out to Dose. I found out about Dose 1 through his project Godark. I remember finding Godark back in 2020. Having nothing better to do, I just used to scroll through Bandcamp and click on people's profiles to see what they had in their library. I think I found Wannabeast by Godark on a profile that I had found from another album that I found in another profile that I found from Machine Girl's album U-Void Synth. Some amount of degree of separation later, and I was looking up the music video on YouTube and just jamming out. Dose is a hard-working motherfucker too. This man puts out so much music, I love all of it. The world is a better place with Dose. Needless to say, Dose provided the soundtrack for Disc Room, and of course it slaps. Such is the nature of this video, I must replace it with an album that I think can square up against the OST. So let's put the freshman up against the veteran. Machine Girl's U-Void Synthesizer is the 2020 album from the hardcore electronic musician. This shit goes insane. The opening track, The Fortress, is such a grimy and disgusting pit anthem. I think it has like 8 breakdowns. No one is leaving that fucking pit. I also like how some of the tracks, like Blood Magic, sound like they could have been used for the space levels in Crash Bandicoot. Machine Girl created the OST for Neon White, which I mentioned in my first media mashup video. I kind of forget what I'm talking about here, so let's just move on. This fucking video is scuffed. Man, you know what I can't stand? How expensive everything is. I mean, we're constantly being advertised to and constantly being reminded to buy the newest product, the shiny newest gems for which we need to decorate our nest. So many things to buy, so many things to try, so many things to use once and then forget about. The landfill transplant from store to home to trash to sea. The subscriptions, the advertising, the monthly renewals, the marketing. If only there was a way to reduce spending by sharing information with each other. I mean, someone still has to buy the sugar so that they can lend a cup. But why should we care what other people are doing with their legally purchased sugar? Copyright-pilled, good, moral individuals will staunchly stand on their ground that this is stealing. Go off, you have every right to believe that. I mean, imagine if someone purchased a piece of digital media and then one day, without their consent, that piece of digital media was altered in some way. For example, deleted and permanently removed. That digital media would no longer be in the ownership of that owner. Copyright Chan's simps will remind you that as the buyer of copyrighted material, you are not the owner of that material, but you are simply licensing it. Kind of like how you are only licensing the material from streaming services. At least you don't have to pay subscriptions for something like your digital media files or their copyrights. If only you had access to picking up an Android tablet, perhaps through a secondhand store.
Thank you for choosing Kinito Pet. To start your download, press the button labeled
Kinito is a personal assistant that you can download on your computer. He has adaptive capabilities to help make your experience online better. Let Kinito know more about you and he'll plan fun activities for you to participate in.
To tell me information, simply type your input in the box and press OK. That's strange. I have never heard of that name before. Are you sure that this is your real name? Oh, in that case, nice to meet you.
Kinito is your best friend. He's always there for you. He's always around when you need him. Kinito knows everything about you, and he knows your deepest secrets. Take Kinito with you everywhere, or just stay home with Kinito forever. There's no reason to leave when Kenito is around. Kenito will always be there whenever you need him. Kenito doesn't really listen to music, but he also loves to listen to what you like to listen to. So Kenito would probably make the recommendation for you to listen to Interbeing by Fire Tools. It's really nice to listen to while you're playing Minesweeper. Kenito wants to plan a fun day for you. He's designed a whole world for just you, where you can go and listen to your new favorite album. He'll invite your friends so that you won't be alone, and even brought some games for you to play. Look at that. When I listen to this album, I feel like I'm taking a walk. Then maybe on that walk I come across a fountain. The water rinsing over the marble fixture, and inside of the basin are hundreds of coins. Hundreds of wishes, or maybe hundreds of requests to remove evil from hundreds of lives. The fountain feels like a place I could go to purge the evils plaguing me. Thanks, Kenito. I love you. I wanted to shout out a few more albums I've been really into lately. If you have any albums that you think are really greatly underrated or underappreciated, share them below in the comments. I love Ween, and the more I hear from the brothers Ween, the less I feel alone. Chocolate and Cheese is a certified hood classic. Unmarked Boxes by Dachma is a solid ambient metal album. I've never been good at math, but about half of this band worked on Bloodletter by Mountaineer, which is also another solid good metal album. Cats Come to Me is a single by Starslinger. I discovered it when I was like fucking 13, but more recently I rediscovered it after 5 years of not listening to it, and it fucking cracks me up. Starslinger's album with Teams is also a great 6-track dance and hip-hop standard. Magazine by Hellcom has been one of those albums that when I don't know what to listen to, I almost always default to that album. It feels like a dream. It's slow and deeply layered at times, but then there are these bursts of color and expression that tickle that part of my monkey brain that wants to be distracted. For fans of Clams, Casino, and Vaporwave. Also, if you aren't listening to Sharky, what the fuck are you doing with your life? Check out People Are Strange by Sharky. It's glitzy Britpop and dancey. This is Sharky's first long play album, and it feels like a coming of age moment in her discography. For dessert, we have a game that is all about a fundamental and human sensation, and one that is high up on Maslow's hierarchy of needs pyramid. Carrion is all about quitting your job. Not so much because of the quitting your job parallel, but more of the energy and tone for the album. We'll be pairing it with In Isolated Minds, I'm Losing Myself. Carrion is yet another game published by Devolver Digital. Do you get it yet? I'm a gamer girl for Devolver. Hey guys, can I get a Volvi merch? I mean, can you send me one of those fucking things? I need like a Volvi pullover or maybe a Volvi decal for my car. You catch me out here driving around in my Volvi Volvo. I don't drive a Volvo, I'm not made of money. Yet, Devolver, hit me up for brand sponsoring. I'll turn this entire fucking nation to Devolver heads. I'll replace the National Weather and Emergency tones with the Son of Ra songs that have us over here permanently vibing out to Coconuts, the musician, but also that one song, Coconuts. That shit is also a certified hood classic. Carrion is something. It play as like a mass of flesh. You get to live out your dreams of consuming, ravage through a high security. I mean, this is what it looks like, okay? You're seeing it on the screen. I don't need to describe this shit to you. You're just consuming everything, okay? I wrote more fucking words here, but do you really need me to tell you more about this game? I mean, look at it. This is the entire game. You just do this, alright? You just move through these fucking compounds. You just rip people to shreds. It's cool, man. Like, just check it out. It's cool. I mean, If you found this video helpful in discovering a new game or new music that you like, please share it with me. I live for the satisfaction of sharing things with people and hearing how much they liked it. I'm just a greedy little pig. Please let me know which games and albums you'd like me to check out or talk about next. I'm kind of broke as fuck right now, but I'll find a way to make it happen. My next video might be a while out from dropping. I would like to switch it up. There's a project I want to work on that's not really video game related, but we'll see how it goes. So until next time, keep it real, be polite, and do good unto others, and pick up a hobby. Later, skaters. Don't forget to tip.